Good morning. I invite you all for the Anderson Hall prayer. Let us sing the song as given in the screen. So for our today's meditation, let us read Psalms 34:8. It's a well-known verse, "O taste and see that the Lord is good." So this verse, if we compile it, and we can say that it consists of two parts. The first part is taste and see that the Lord is good. So this particular part talks about the confirmation, promise given and protection given by our Lord Jesus when He saved us, when He put us out from the miry clay and set our feet on the rock. Second part is the connection what we have with our Lord. It talks about the intimacy of us towards God's love. First part, when everything is going on good, we always say that our Lord is good and He has done mighty things. And He made me to triumph in all the ways. But when the days goes by, we'll just like that, we leave the love of God and we'll go back. But it is very necessary that how far we are connected with God is very, very important. So let me tell you with three things that how we can restore our thing, or how we can make our connection with God as a confident one, and how we can increase the intimacy with God, and we can say in each and every path how God is good and how it tastes like honey in our life. So first one is the unconditional faith. So when two person is in love with each other, if they proceed with an unconditional love and unconditional faith, then one can very well experience this taste like honey in their life. For example, if we can take that fowls of the air, just a simple example I'm taking, according to Matthew 6:26, the fowls of the air does not sow, does not reap, does not gather it in the barn, but they know that they will be fed by their Creator. So this unconditional faith they had, so they are very much happy in their life. They doesn't have any problems in their path. So like that, we should also try to move in our path, to proceed in our life without any expectation. So expectation, if the expectation comes, means automatically tasting like honey experience will go off. So it is better to have a life without any expectation, with God, in faith life. Next one is the longingness. If we look on to the Psalms 42:1, we can see that the deer longeth for water, as likewise my soul also longeth for you, O God. So the same thing, that is, we, our soul should be in a position to long for the word of God. We should be always looking for the words, comforting words, strengthening words, whatever is coming through our Christ, such that we can set up our life accordingly and we can transform ourselves to be with our Lord, and we can transform ourselves to be in His own likeness. So this will help us to grow in the godly nature. So automatically, if we long to sit at His feet to receive His words, we will be able to refine our characters and we will become as God. And third one is young lions. Normally, young lions, they are very furious, courageous. They are very strong enough to catch their prey. They cannot go back without achieving the things what they have deserved of. So the same character will be there in young lions, but they do lack and hunger. According to Psalms 34:10, young lions go lacking in hunger, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. So here I want to highlight here is seeking the Lord. Seeking the Lord means just like that, for name's sake, seeking is not good. It is good and better if we seek the Lord diligently, day and night, with His whole heart and with our whole spirit. With this characteristics, if we are able to seek the Lord, and if we are able to long for the word of God, and if we are able to lead a life without any expectations, then we can very well say in our life that my Lord is sweeter than honey to me. So with these words, let us all bow down our heads. Heavenly Father, I praise and thank Thee for giving this opportunity to be in Your presence, Lord. Lord, help us to lead a life without an expectation, with an unconditional faith, with a longingness for Your words, and to seek You diligently day and night. Lord, help us to be with You when You come in glory. Help our administrators take hold of Your college, students and staffs in Your mighty hand, and lead them according to Your own will, and make them to be the partakers of Your kingdom. Amen.